CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 2.7, Explain Basic Networking Concepts. DNS. DNS stands for Domain Name System, and it's like a phone book for the internet. DNS is a system used in computer networking to translate human-readable website names into their corresponding numerical IP addresses. Essentially, DNS enables us to access websites using memorable names instead of complex numerical IP addresses. So how does DNS translate a website name to its IP address? It starts when you type a website name, known as a URL, or Uniform Resource Locator, into your browser. The URL has multiple parts. Using the graphic behind me and starting at the left, there is the protocol, the subdomain, the domain name, and the top-level domain, and the file path. For example, in the URL, https://www.example.com/info/about-us.html. The protocol is HTTPS, which is a protocol for secure web traffic. The subdomain is www, which stands for World Wide Web. The domain is example. The top-level domain is .com. And the file path is info/about-us.html. When you hit enter, your browser sends a request to a DNS resolver, which is a server that handles DNS queries or requests for information. The resolver then begins the process of looking up the IP address associated with the domain name you entered. When you hit enter, your browser sends a request to a DNS recursive server, which begins the process of looking up the IP address associated with the domain name you entered. The first stop is a root server. A root name server provides a referral to the appropriate top-level domain server. For our scenario, the .com TLD server. The DNS recursive server then reaches out to the TLD server, which then directs the DNS recursive server to the domain name server responsible for the specific domain. The domain name server will then return the IP address associated with the domain to the DNS recursive server. The DNS recursive server will complete the lookup process by providing the requested IP address back to your browser. Now that we know how the DNS lookup process works, let's take another look at the URL and see how much you learned. Which part of the URL correlated to the location where the IP address was actually stored? That is right. The domain, example, was the portion of the URL that led us to the domain name server where the IP address information or record was stored. In addition to translating website names to IP addresses, DNS also plays a role in translating device names within a local area network. In a home or office network, devices such as workstations, laptops, printers, and other network-enabled devices are often assigned human-readable names for easy identification and communication. For example, a printer might be named Office Printer or a laptop might be named John's Laptop. When devices on the local network need to communicate with each other, they can use these friendly names instead of IP addresses. The local DNS server, often provided by the router or a network server, maintains a database of these device names and their corresponding IP addresses. This allows devices to communicate efficiently within the local area network, making it simpler for users to access and share resources without needing to remember complex IP addresses. Thank goodness we have DNS to make our lives easier. I would hate to have a bunch of sticky notes all over my desk just to be able to visit my favorite websites. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.